Hi everyone, it's Nono here, and this is a really quick video on how you can run TensorFlow on your machine inside of Docker, even if TensorFlow cannot be installed with pip or with Python on your machine, right? For newcomers, people who don't know this, Docker is a program that lets us virtualize Linux machines and other types of machines in our Mac or Windows, and TensorFlow is a machine learning framework by Google, which if you're here, you probably know already. All right, quick reminder, please like the video if you would like to see more content or you enjoyed this video, and subscribe and click on the bell if you're gonna get notified when I upload new videos. All right, we have three commands here. The first one is docker run it. So docker and run basically just runs a new container using an image that you give it. Here, the important part is the I flag that is going to create an interactive session for us. You have here Python 3.9 Slim, which is the image that we're gonna use on our container. And we have bash, so we start an interactive session. When we have the interactive session, we'll be able to run pip install TensorFlow, TensorFlow.io. This is TensorFlow and the TensorFlow.io packet, so I can then run the Python command that I have in the code, right? All right, so let's actually take a look at how to do that. I have a window here, and I also have Docker. If I run here docker run interactively and I select the Python 3.9 Slim image, I'm going to say I want to start a bash session. And I'm going to actually name this TF so we know what container we're talking about. This gets started really quickly. I already have this Python image on my machine. In yours, you might have to download it. And we can see here that indeed we have that new container that has a Python image called TF here. We could stop it or we could do whatever. When we exit, we'll see that this actually gets stopped. How do we get back to it? If we get stopped, we click play. We now run here docker exec it, the name of the container, and then what command we want to run on it. All right, so we're back on our container. Now I can check here that I have Python 3 and that I have pip, and we're going to straightforward do pip install TensorFlow and TensorFlow.io. This is going to take some time, and I'm going to explain a few things here. This is installing TensorFlow not on your machine, but on a virtualized machine that is actually a Linux machine. Indeed, you can actually see that it's installing TensorFlow CPU AWS. That's a specific build of TensorFlow that is meant to run on cloud instances, probably on AWS, right? That's Amazon Web Services. After all these packages have been resolved, pip is installing them on that container. Remember, this container is running in this Docker container. And if I delete or stop that container, TensorFlow is like, it's not installed on your machine anymore. If you don't delete the container after stopping it, you can connect back to it and continue using TensorFlow. All right, so it seems like that's done. So I'm going to click here on Python, verify that the same Python version is present if I just do Python. So I'm going to go into Python. I'm going to import TensorFlow as TF. We're going to first print to see what TensorFlow version I have. And now we can test a few operations here. So for example, TF constant is going to return a constant, and convert to tensor with a simple Python array is going to return a tensor shape 3.0. All right, I think this is it. So this was Nono Martinez Alonso with a really quick video on how to run TensorFlow on your machine. Remember, you can like this video if you want to let me know that this was something useful for you. And don't forget to subscribe and click on that bell if you're gonna get notified when I upload new videos. For those of you who are still there, I'm going to show really one quick thing that clarifies everything, I think. If I exit again, Python and the container, you can see here that that container is still running. I can stop it. So we can stop the container. We can reattach to it and I'm back at it, right? But what happens if I now try to use my Python version of my Mac and try to actually do that? So TensorFlow as TF. So TensorFlow is not there. All you have to do is go back to your container, start it, and once that's started, you just run docker exec interactive, the name of your container, and then you can directly prompt the Python 3 command to get a Python session. Here we'll have TensorFlow as TF, and you can see that that's being properly imported. All right, it was Nono Martinez Alonso here. Thanks a lot for watching, and I'll see you next time.